Welcome back to HealthWatch, presented by Novant Health. I'm your host, June Baker. As always, our show features local physicians and health professionals discussing health topics of importance to local residents. Today, we'll meet two of Novant Health's newest team members, Jill Ward, Novant Health's new chief nursing officer, and Lisa Smith, who is the hospital's new emergency department manager. Then we'll meet Dr. Joseph Kibler, a local podiatrist, and Danae Blanks, a wound care nurse with Novant Health. Stay tuned to learn about valuable health topics with HealthWatch. Our first guest today is Jill Ward, Novant Health Brunswick Medical Center's Chief Nursing Officer. Thank you for joining us today, Jill. It's such a pleasure to have you here.
Thank you.
Well, how about start by sharing a little bit about your education and your background for our viewers?
Okay. I've been a nurse for 26 years.
Wow.
15 of those years have been in leadership roles. Mm-hmm. I have a Master's of Science in Nursing, and I have a background with critical care, mm-hmm. Emergency department, operating room, and pediatrics.
Great. It's a varied background. You have
yes.
a lot of...
It's very well rounded.
Good. Yeah, mm-hmm. good experience. Now, I understand that you're originally from this area. Is that correct?
That is correct, June. I'm from Columbus County. I'm a native.
You're a local girl.
Yes, I yeah. am.
Oh, nice. What made you decide to come back to this area? Because I believe you just moved here, back here recently, correct?
Just in November. Mm-hmm. I have family here in the area.
Nice.
My parents, my in-laws, my siblings, all of them live in the area.
So uh-huh. Primarily in Columbus County?
Columbus. Mm-hmm.
Wow. Well, we're here today to talk about your role as Novant Health Brunswick Medical Center's Chief Nursing Officer.
Yes.
So tell me a little bit about that role. What does that entail?
Well, June, basically I oversee all of nursing on campus. I'm responsible for making sure nurses have all the tools and equipment they do mm-hmm. or use to do their job. I'm responsible for making sure that they stay licensed and that they excel in their roles and that they really work off of evidence-based practice.
Mm-hmm. Well, I assume that you have relationships with the other leaders at the hospital, correct? You probably, I would assume that departments cross over and talk to me a little bit about how that communication occurs.
Absolutely. We have a wonderful team of leaders at the hospital. Mm-hmm. They're all very smart, love what they do, very dedicated to patient care. And, you know, we don't work in silos. We have to work together to promote you know, the best, most remarkable experience our patient can have and really mm-hmm. Work together to make sure the quality that we present for our patients is really well.
Mm-hmm. What would you say your primary focus areas are or your biggest projects currently?
Well, our biggest projects, you know, is really patient satisfaction to make sure that we're mm-hmm. doing all the things that we need to do to make sure when patients come through our doors that they really have a remarkable experience and that they really see Novant as the place they want to come for their health care. And we work really hard listening to our families, the feedback mm-hmm. they give us. We really take that to heart and trying to, you
That's
know,
wonderful.
To correct anything that they find that they just don't like, mm-hmm. which is, you know, currently I haven't really seen a lot. People really are very complimentary of mm-hmm. the staff and of the care they receive, mm-hmm. which is exciting.
That's great. That's mm-hmm. that's good to hear. While you're here, I wanted to, I heard about the new nursing recognition program, mm-hmm. and I want to talk a little bit about that.
Yes. We started the Daisy Foundation. We didn't start it. It actually, we partnered with them. It's a organization that was created in 1999 by the Patrick Barnes family. Mm-hmm. Their son was 33 years old and passed away from an autoimmune disease. Mm-hmm. And they started this foundation across the world. And so we partnered with them in October of 2016. And what it entails is it really brings highlight to those caregivers that take care of patients that really, really stand out. Their kindness, their compassion really affects the family and the patients during their hospital stay. You can nominate a nurse anytime you come through the door at Novant. You'll find these little green boxes with daisies on them throughout the organization. And there are documents that you could fill out and really talk about your experience with the nurses there and drop them in that box.
I have to share something with you. I just learned about this program the other day, and I learned it from my daughter-in-law, Christy Baker, who is a nurse in Asheville, and she received this award, and it blew her away. She's so honored to receive that award. And so I know how important it was to her, and I think that's great for Novant Health to have that program here too. What has been the reception here? How have they?
I think it's been very, very overwhelming. The nurses, when they receive it, they have no idea they're getting it.
I know.
And they're totally, I think they're amazed by it, because it is such a great, it's a great thing to be able to say, I'm a Daisy nurse.
Well, how are the nurses chosen? And
we have a committee, and the committee members are team members within the hospital. They collect the ballots out of the boxes. They blind them, so the staff that actually looks at the nominations, they don't really know who the nursing staff is. It's blinded. And so they review them at the committee, and the committee comes up with the one that they really think is just outstanding. And so that's how they're nominated.
And here locally, what do they receive?
They, with the organization, they get a sculpture of the Healer's Touch, which is really,
it's
really
lovely.
Pretty.
I've seen it.
We have the big, huge sculpture come into the front of the hospital when you enter
that's
the door,
nice.
So it really, you'll see, you'll see that. But they get a smaller version of the sculpture. They also, they receive special benefits if they're not, they don't have their baccalaureate degree or their master's, they can go back to school through Chamberlain School of Nursing and they get a discount.
Nice.
If they want to be certified and they're not a certified nurse as of yet, the foundation will actually give them discounts to be able to become certified.
That's nice.
So it's really, it's nice.
That's a wonderful program. It,
yes.
It is. And thanks so much for sharing that information with us today. I think that's a wonderful program for all that are involved. So is there anything that you would like to add before we close today?
I would. We also have another foundation at the hospital that really focuses on nursing education, the Angie Fisher Foundation. And for me, being a new CNO to the area, it was such an honor for me to be able to really promote her foundation and really help her legacy continue throughout our facility.
She was a wonderful person, and we all miss her greatly.
I know the hospital does. I feel it.
Well, thanks again for being here today, and I look forward to having you back.
Thank you.
Our next guest is Lisa Smith, Novant Health Brunswick Medical Center's Emergency Department Manager. Welcome, Lisa. It's a pleasure to have you.
Thank you. It's great to be here.
Good. First, I want to start by learning a little bit about you. So tell our viewers a little bit about your background.
Well, I moved here 11 years ago from High Point, North Carolina. I have an associate degree in paralegal work. I worked in the law for 15 years.
Well, that's interesting.
And then became a nurse. So I have lived here for a little over 11 years.
Wow. Tell me about your role at the hospital. What is it that you do?
I am the emergency services nurse manager, and I am responsible for the organizational process of the department. That also entails being an advocate for the patients, the families, and also for the staff. I get to participate in watching the staff grow professionally and personally.
Yeah, that's nice. How long have you had the role of emergency department manager?
I was interim manager, made interim manager August of 2016, mm-hmm. and then became the permanent manager November 2016.
Mm-hmm. Well, I know that the emergency department is very busy. That's just one of the busiest departments in the whole mm-hmm. hospital. But what would you say is the most common issue that you see in the emergency department at Novant Health Brunswick Medical Center?
We see a well-balanced group of people mm-hmm. from the community, I think, and also the people who are traveling here. We have big travel industry here.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we do.
So we see a lot of respiratory, mm-hmm. we see a lot of gastroenterological issues. We also have continued to see a growing amount of stroke patients, mm-hmm. And we have an excellent stroke process.
Mm-hmm. Well, I suspect that there are different things that you see more of certain things in the summer versus the winter. Talk to me a little bit about that.
Yeah, in the winter we see this time of year we see a lot of the respiratory and a lot of the flu. Mm-hmm. So I would just remind our community to make sure that they wash their hands to keep from spreading it. Cover their cough, and also if they do come into the hospital, to wear a mask. It's not only for their protection, mm-hmm. also for others' protection. And during the summertime, we see jellyfish and stingray injuries. We also see quite a few lacerations from oyster shells.
Oh, yeah, those are sharp.
We also have an occasional shark bite.
Yeah, that's true.
And then we see, we do unfortunately see some near drownings and drownings.
Yeah, yeah. And those are sad times. I know that oftentimes when you go to the emergency department, you're not sure what to expect. So talk to me a little bit about the process and what patients might expect upon entry to the emergency room.
When they first come into the department, they will be greeted by our registration personnel and also by guest services, and they will get them registered for their visit. Mm-hmm. And then if we have rooms in the back, they will be taken straight back to be okay. treated. Mm-hmm. If we do not have rooms in the back, then they will go through a triage process with a nurse out front. Once they get in the back, they will be seen by a nurse and by a provider, and then any of our ancillary departments that their condition requires, like radiology, lab, those different ancillary departments.
Mm-hmm. I know that oftentimes there are long waits in the emergency department, and sometimes it's just out of control, there are too many patients or what have you. But how do you prioritize which patients get seen first?
We prioritize by the severity of the condition, mm-hmm. and obviously whoever we feel like needs to be seen first that's more critical is who we will take back first. Mm-hmm. It's not necessarily on a first come, first serve basis.
And I think sometimes folks think that's how it should be or is, and are discouraged when they see somebody go ahead of them.
Right. We have 22 rooms in the emergency department, uh-huh. two of those being trauma bays. We have a 11 rooms where we see our higher acuity patients, mm-hmm. and then we have a fast track side where we see patients with the lacerations and the breaks and those kinds of things. Mm-hmm. So they will go back to that care station one side based on the severity of their condition. Mm-hmm. However, sometimes patients will get taken back to that care station two side because they are in and out quicker mm-hmm. than on the other side. Mm-hmm. We have reduced our doctor to patient time or our door to patient time from 23 minutes this year down to 9 minutes.
Wow, that's quite a drop.
So we have had more providers mm-hmm. over this last 6 to 8 months.
Mm-hmm. Well, this has been really helpful for me. Is there anything else that you would like to add before we close today?
I would just like to say that through our service standards, the know me, respect me, delight me, and care about me, our emergency department provides excellent care.
Thank you so much for being here today. It's been a pleasure to have you, and welcome to the emergency department, your new role in the emergency department. So we appreciate you coming.
Thank you.
Our next guest is Dr. Joseph Kibler, a local podiatrist. Welcome back to the show today, Dr. Kibler. It's a pleasure to have you here.
Thank you for having me again.
Yeah, it's been a long time.
It's been several years.
Yeah. Well, how long have you been in Brunswick County, though?
It's
several
growing,
years.
Yes, by years. Last count, 13 years.
So you're almost a native, but not quite.
Almost a native.
Just yes. Not quite.
not quite yet.
Well, I want to talk about your practice today. Tell us where your practice is located.
We are next to the old Brunswick Hospital on 17 in Supply. And we've been there for the full 13 years. Mm-hmm. We serve all of Brunswick County.
Great. Well, let's talk about the various services that you offer there at your practice.
Sure. As a podiatrist, I certainly offer all basic podiatry services, such as things like ingrown toenails, diabetic foot treatments, diabetic foot infections. We also start specializing in things like heel pain, plantar fasciitis, tendonitis. Mm-hmm. And we also treat broken bones, foot and ankle fractures. We do a lot of foot and ankle surgery as well. Bunions, hammer toes, Achilles tendon problems, ankle arthritis. We really run the full gamut of anything you can think of the foot and ankle being a problem, we can take care of.
Mm-hmm. And the surgeries that you spoke of, where do you perform your surgeries?
Primarily at Brunswick Novant Medical Center. Mm-hmm. We also are staff at Dozier Memorial Hospital.
Good to know. Well, I hear that you have a new nail spa, and I want to concentrate on that today. I'm really excited about that, and I think that's a great topic for our viewers. So tell me about I believe it's a medical nail spa.
Correct.
Is that correct?
Correct, yeah. It came about, it's sort of organically developed over time. I've been thinking about it for quite a while because I would see people coming into the office, and they were coming in with ingrown toenails, infections of fungus, and some of them were getting quite severe. Mm-hmm. And there was always like, well, how long has this been going on? Well, a few months since I went to get a pedicure. And after a while, I said, enough is enough. Not that all pedicures are a problem, but there are some that can become an issue. And I wanted to be able to provide the people in this area a place where they can safely cleanly get a pedicure done. Mm-hmm. And so I created the O Medi Nails and Spa, and we expanded that to not only include pedicures, but manicures and spa treatments, such as aesthetics that include facials and waxings as well. So we've kind of taken the basic, just we need to provide some safe, clean pedicures and have expanded it.
Well, and that's really important for folks with diabetes. Is that correct?
Absolutely correct. Some people come in to see me because they are diabetic, and some people with diabetes have poor circulation.
Right.
And it can be very dangerous for them to take care of their own toes or calluses and things that they may develop that need to be treated. But there's a lot of diabetics that don't have poor circulation. And they may not necessarily have to have the doctor be doing the care on a regular basis, but they need to go to a place that's safe and clean. Mm-hmm. And that's why we sterilize all of our equipment in autoclaves. We use all reusable, disposable equipment.
Right.
All of the foot spas are thrown out at the end of the treatments.
And there are no drains or anything like that?
No drains or anything that could be recirculating, harboring fungus or harboring bacteria.
Yeah. Now, I know it's next door to your practice.
Correct.
So I would imagine that you have a relationship with the spa itself. And so probably you would get involved if
So occasionally my nail technician will call me and I'll be seeing patients in my office and say, can you come over and take a look at this client? I've noticed that she may be getting an ingrown toenail. What do you think? Or I'm noticing that she might have a fungus infection. should she be treated first so then we can treat it and then, you know, allow her to go back to the spa on a long-term basis.
Mm-hmm.
Even just yesterday, she saw a patient was wondering if she had, the patient may have had a skin cancer. And I was able to go over and take a look and reassure the patient it was probably not a skin cancer, but, you know, be able to jump back and forth if needed, you know, is very nice.
Right, yeah. So when, do you recommend for folks with diabetes that they have some, a professional cut their toenails rather than doing it themselves?
I do, especially for patients, again, who maybe have poor circulation, and a lot of diabetics have numb feet, or we call peripheral neuropathy. So if they can't feel their toes or can't feel their, you know, skin, it is particularly dangerous for that, for them to be trimming their own nails. But even for people without those problems, it's always a good idea because when you're diabetic, sometimes the immune system doesn't work so well because of the diabetes. And so people with diabetes are much more prone to develop fungal infections of the skin and of the toenails. And because of that, we really want to be very careful and make sure that it's exceptionally clean whenever it's done. So even though if it doesn't have to be done by the doctor because of, let's say, poor circulation or nerve damage, then it can still be done by the nail technician, but again, in a clean, safe environment.
So if folks already have a toenail fungus, can they be treated at the MediSpa?
The MediSpa does not treat the fungus.
Right.
They would refer them to my office, and we would discuss different options. The first thing we would do is we actually test the toenail, because approximately 30% of all the nails that people think they have fungus in
don't
have fungus. And they'll argue with me, and sometimes, oh, I definitely have fungus. Well, let's let the test determine it.
Yeah.
And the tests come back from the lab and there's no fungus found.
So
it's very important to get the test done, and we have many different treatments for that.
Well, if folks want to make an appointment, how might they do that?
Okay, to make an appointment for my medical office, they would go to InStride Brunswick Foot and Ankle Surgery, or call us at 910-755-6512. And for the nail spa, omedinailspa.com or 910-754-9596.
Wonderful. Well, thank you so much for being here today. I hope to have you back real soon, and we'll talk about it some more.
Thanks for inviting me, Jean.
Thank you. Our last guest today is Danae Blanks, a wound care nurse with Novant Health. Welcome to the show today, Danae. It's such a pleasure to have you here.
Thank you for having me.
Well, you're quite welcome. So let's talk about your role at Novant Health. Tell me what you do.
I am their certified wound ostomy nurse, and I believe I'm the only one in this county.
Wow. I didn't know that.
Yes.
That's pretty awesome. How do you get to be an ostomy or
It's called a wound ostomy nurse.
Okay. Well, how does, what is your background and your education, and how do you become one of those?
Well, first off, you have to have a bachelor's, and I do have a bachelor's, and then I also have a bachelor's with journalism and marketing, and later in life, I decided to be a nurse, and I went on and got my nursing degree, and then from there, after working on the floor, you had to have at least 2 years' experience, and after working on the floor, I got approached if I would be interested, because I did the wound care at another facility, if I would be interested in going to school, and I ended up going to Emory Medical University, the School of Nursing, and got all my certifications. But then you have to test nationally in each area for either wounds, ostomy, or continence. And I am just wounds and ostomies. So you test every 5 years to keep your credentialing so that you can practice as a wound ostomy nurse.
Well, that's interesting. I wasn't aware of all that. Today we specifically wanted to talk a little bit about the wound care services offered by Novant Health. Now I know that you said you split your time, half your time with Novant Health at the hospital and then with Oceanside Family Medicine and Convenient Care in Shalhoub.
Correct.
So tell us about the types of services that you offer in the hospital, say.
In the hospital, I work very closely with all of the physicians. more so with the surgeons and the orthopedic side, and I get and I'm with the hospitalist, and I work with anything from I go into surgery often and help with severe dressings, or if someone is going to end up with an ostomy bag, I'll go in and work with their anatomy to figure out what will fit them the best. If I'm not in the surgery part of it, then I'm on the floor and I'm working with anything from vascular issues, alterations to the legs, to decubitus, to someone having a traumatic injury. And I work with that person and their lifestyle to figure out what I can do to help their tissue grow back. And as far as with the ostomy side of it, if they end up with an ostomy bag, I begin the education usually before the surgery. And then I work with them for a very prolonged time after to help them learn to manage their change in lifestyle.
So when you're performing your duties at the hospital, those are primarily patients who are there for overnight stays, correct?
Yes.
But then when you see patients at Oceanside Family Medicine and Convenient Care in Shallotte, what kind of services would you offer there?
I offer the same, because what usually ends up happening, even though you're discharged, because you know length of stay is very short. Once you're done at the hospital, you need follow-up care. And I work with the home health agencies a lot of times, and then I work with the physicians, and they come. The physicians will send the patients to me, and I will continue to work with them to get that wound to heal, wherever it may be. And it's not just about the wound. I work with them on their diet to help them get the right nutrition to help it heal, and so forth.
So primarily then you're following up on the patients who have been discharged from the hospital.
Often I am.
And then I assume that anytime a tissue breaks down or and they're just a patient there at Oceanside Family Medicine, you would probably follow up with them.
But in order for them to see me, they do get referred to me through a physician, and we work it through it that way.
Can physicians other than Novant Health Medical Group physicians refer to you?
Absolutely. I'm getting them from down in North and South Myrtle Beach. I'm getting them from the other side of Wilmington already. Ash, Wifel. I'm getting them from everywhere. So as long as they usually call in, find out what they need to do, the process in order to get the referral through the system, and we go from there. And then I call the patient and set everything up.
And so you would see that patient then in Shallotte, is that correct?
Correct. Outpatients, 100% Shallotte.
Well, do patients call you directly sometimes for appointments? How does that work?
My name's out in the community.
They just hear about
you. They hear about me and they say so-and-so from church or however, and they'll call me directly. And what I end up doing then is directing them how to get in touch with their physician to get the referral through. And usually I know that physician as well. I will place a call and say, I had a concern from this one of your patients. Would you like me to see them? And I haven't had anyone say no yet.
So you get referrals from primary care and from surgeons' offices and
just everywhere.
Everywhere.
I get them a lot from your, from literally from everywhere.
Wow.
Plastics. I get a lot of plastics.
It sounds like there is a huge need for your type of service.
There is. I usually am back to back. I average probably anywhere from 10 to 15 patients hands on a day.
Wow.
Five days a week.
Well, I'm so glad you were here today, because it sounds like it's something that we really need to talk about out there in the community that folks know where these services are available. So, how might we reach you? How might they reach you to schedule?
I think the simplest way would be just to call one of my main office numbers. And do you want me to, I can state it. It's 910-721-2018. Just call it, leave me a message, and I'll get back in touch with you at the quickest I can.
And we can run that on the bottom
that
of the screen, too. That way folks will know. Well, thank you so much for being on the show today.
Sure.
It's a very interesting topic that I know absolutely nothing about. So it was a great to have you here, and I hope you'll come back and tell us how it's going.
Absolutely.
Great.
Thank you for having me.
You're welcome. Thank you for tuning in to ATMC-TV's HealthWatch. I hope this information was beneficial for you and your family. If you have any questions or topics that you would like to see discussed on a future show, please email them to atmctv@atmc.com. For more information on Novant Health Brunswick Medical Center, local doctors, and general health info, visit novanthealth.org. Thanks again for joining us today. Be sure to join us next time for HealthWatch on ATMC TV.